wishing you a very good morning. This is Dr. Neha Khodke and I welcome you to the next session of Zomio Classroom. The remedy that we are going to study today is generally thought of whenever the patient presents with an extreme form of chilliness, a lot of oversensitivity, and a very characteristic dry cough. I am talking about Heparsulf. Now, we know that all of these are the characteristic indications of Heparsulf. Add to it, if there is any evidence of suppuration, we know that Heparsulf is in the front running. But how is Heparsulf as a person? Can Heparsulf be prescribed as a constitutional medicine? Does it have a constitution? Does it have a peculiar or specific life situation? Yes, it does. And that is exactly what we are going to study today. Through the mental picture, we will be able to understand why certain physical characteristics arise in Heparsulf. Remember, everything starts from the mind and then it manifests on the body. So let us start with Heparsulf. Now, Heparsulf, how is it prepared? What is it actually? For that, let us go to a source book and read how Heparsulf has actually been made. So, if you would like to see how a remedy is prepared from any particular book, what we do is click on the module Remedy. So let us go to the software right at the start. Click on Remedy from the topmost menu bar and click Remedy List. Alternatively, you can also press Command E from the keyboard. Once we click on the left-hand side is the entire list of remedies that are represented in Homepath Zomio. Now, since we are looking for information about Heparsulf, let's directly jump to that remedy. To do that, in the search bar, just enter the word Hepar. Once you do that, the list drills down to those remedies that contain the word H-E-P-A-R. Now we are looking for the remedy Hepar Sulfurous Calcareum, which is here in the software represented as the abbreviation H-E-P. When I click on it, on the right hand side, I see reflected the properties of Heparsulf. Now look carefully at its common name. To read this information better, let us increase the font size. To increase the font size, all you have to do is drag the cursor of the font line towards the right, and the font size automatically starts increasing. Now, if you look at the common name, it's very interesting. It is an impure form of calcium sulfide. Now, calcium sulfide is represented in homeopathy as a separate remedy, Calcarea sulfuricum. We have Calcarea sulfuricum in the homeopathic form as well as the biochemic form. Heparsulf calcareum is the impure form of Calcarea sulf. Why is that? For that, we need to look into how this remedy is prepared. Let us read about the information about Heparsulf from a source book. And what better source book than the book written by the father of homeopathy himself? We will be looking and reading Heparsulf from Chronic Diseases. Now, to access this book, click on the drop-down arrow represented next to the word properties on the blue taskbar. Since we are looking for a particular reference book for Heparsulf, we will click on Reference Book. Now, the first book that opens in alphabetical order is A Comparison of Arsenic, Nitric Acid, Heparsulf, and Nux Vomica by Marjorie Blackie. But since we are looking for chronic diseases, let us now go to that book. To refer to that book, click on the drop-down arrow present next to the word books. And by scrolling down in the list, we go to Chronic Diseases, Theory and Practice, Volume 1 by S. Hanneman. Now here is the information given about the exact preparation of Heparsulf. Again, dragging the cursor on the font line towards the right, let's read now. A mixture of equal parts of finely powdered clean oyster shells and quite pure flowers of sulfur is kept for 10 minutes at a white heat in a thermetically closed crucible and afterwards stored up in a well-corked bottle. This is the source material of Heparsulf, and that is why it is an impure form of calcium sulfide. It contains both the elements of calcium as well as sulfur. So when you combine calcium and sulfur in this form, Heparsulf is formed. And that is why, because it is an impure form of calcarea sulf, if you carefully read Heparsulf and calcarea sulf from source books, you will realize that Heparsulf is nothing but the extreme form of calcarea sulf. Calcarea sulf also has festering wounds, also has a feeling of underappreciation that Heparsulf has. But if you look at both remedies, the reactions given by these remedies are totally different, and that is what sets them apart from each other. Where calcarea sulf is more of a suppressed remedy, Heparsulf is an extremely expressive remedy, but to a pathological degree. It is advisable to always express whatever feelings you have, because suppression leads to a lot of health problems. However, even expression needs to be there within limits of normality. If they exceed the limits of normality, they can also lead to a lot of health problems. So, this is the core of Heparsulf. I am suffering through the faults or deeds of others. So, there is always a persecution complex in Heparsulf. He always feels that everything is wrong in his life. And the reason why everything is wrong is because of other people. He himself is not responsible because he feels that I am trying my best, but I am not being appreciated for what I am doing. And that is why I am suffering. In fact, I am being humiliated or put down, even though I am performing very well. This is the core feeling in Heparsulf. So let's look at the main mental characteristics, and we will see how they express in Heparsulf at different levels. The first and most important characteristic is the oversensitivity or hypersensitivity. Heparsulf is extremely sensitive to anything and everything. So anything negative that is said to him, anything bad that is said to him, any even constructive criticism that is given to him is taken in a very, very bad way by Heparsulf. Let us see in what forms this oversensitivity is manifested in Heparsulf. And for that, we have a very wonderful feature in Homepad Zomio called Materia Medica Extract. Now, this feature helps us to understand a remedy through the repertory. It helps to give us a materia medica of a remedy through the repertory, because many times it happens that the entire information about a remedy is either not completely captured in source books, or it is captured completely but it is scattered all across the books. And that is where this feature comes in very handy, because if you are looking for a particular characteristic in a remedy and would like to see how that characteristic expresses itself in that remedy, the materia medica extract brings together the different symptoms that cover that characteristic and give you a complete picture. So let us go to materia medica extract. To access materia medica extract, we once again click on remedy from the topmost menu bar and select the second option, that is remedy extract. Now here on the left hand side is a section where we need to enter those parameters that we are looking for in the remedy. The first is that we need to add the remedy. So when I click on the blank box below add remedy, I get a list of remedies in a pop-up. And now, since I'm looking for the characteristics of Heparsulf, I will type in HEP and I will check the box against the remedy Hepar. I click add. Now I am specifically looking for oversensitive, and that is at the mental level. So I will be looking for the chapters of mind. So clicking on add repertories, I select the chapter mind from the complete repertory. I click done. And now, since I am looking for oversensitive, that is the rubric group that I am looking for, I type in OVERSENS, and as you can see, there are already word suggestions that are being given. So I can select any word suggestion that I want. I will select oversensitive. I would like to see all the rubrics of Heparsulf that contain the word oversensitive. And then I click extract. And now on the right hand side, you can see that there are 11 rubrics mentioned with Heparsulf included in them with the word oversensitive. So the first is the general rubric of sensitive, oversensitive. Now have a look at the sub rubrics. If you will carefully read each sub rubric, you will see that this one word runs through the remedy Heparsulf at each and every level of its mind and body. So oversensitive during chill, oversensitive to all external impressions, where Heparsulf occupies grade 4. Oversensitive to mental impressions. Oversensitive mentally and physically. Oversensitive to moral impressions, to noise, sounds, etc. To odors, to people, to locations, and sensual oversensitiveness. So if you are understanding, Heparsulf is oversensitive to all external impressions, including noise, including odors, including even people talking in a slightly louder tone. Heparsulf will become very, very hyper and very, very irritated. Okay. So the slightest things will cause an irritation. In the rubric form, if you're looking for the slightest things, we think of the word trifles. So instead of the word oversensitive, now let us add the word trifles. And I click extract once again. And if you see that now there are 7 rubrics in the mind chapter of the complete repertory, for the word trifles that contain the remedy hepar. Anger about trifles, where it is present in grade 3. Conscientious about trifles. Irritability about trifles. Morose and sulky about trifles. Trifles, ailments from aggravate. Trifles seem important. And the last is violence or vehemence about trifles. Now, there are only 10 remedies in this rubric. Click on the rubric to see which are the 10 remedies. And now you can see that hepar sulph occupies grade 3 in violence about trifles. There are many remedies that get offended about trifles, that are conscientious about trifles, that are irritated with trifles. But hepar is one of those few remedies in the materia medica that also reacts with a lot of violence to trifling matters. And this is what sets hepar apart from other remedies that get conscientious or irritable about the little things. Because he is so oversensitive and hypersensitive about what people say, and he has this feeling that he is suffering because of others, he tends to be a brooder. But he is not as much of a brooder as an aurum metallicum or a natrum mure or a staphy sagria or a carcinosin. Because hepar is an extremely impulsive person. And because he is an impulsive person, he tends to react very fast. And that is why he spends very little time in actual brooding, discontented. So you can see the overall picture of hepar sulph. Hepar sulph is a very irritated, is a remedy that feels that he is suffering a lot. And that is why there is a lot of discontent in hepar's life. Let's see how this discontentment is reflected in the repertory. Again, in the materia medica extract, in the symptom keyword, we will put the word discontented. Click on extract. And you see there are 6 rubrics for discontentment in hepar. In the first rubric, which is the main rubric, hepar occupies grade 4. And look at the third rubric, discontented always. This is a very, very rare quality to have in people. There are only 5 remedies for always discontented. Cinna, hepar, lachesis, merxol, and nitric acid. These are the 5 remedies that are always discontented and dissatisfied with everything and at all times. And hepar is one of them. So if you get a case in your practice where, you know, the family members say that he is always unhappy with everything, he's not satisfied about anything, and at any time there is no sense of happiness or contentment, then hepar sulph and merxol should be 2 remedies that you should think of first. Hepar sulph and merxol are related remedies. They are very, very close to each other. Okay, so these 2 remedies need to be thought of first. Both of these remedies have violence in them. They have a lot of anger in them. But where merc will first be verbally abusive and then physically abusive, hepar will directly be physically abusive. Hepar will not spend time in any verbal kind of altercation. Because on the other hand, hepar has a brooding tendency. So he tends to keep his feelings inside, but he reacts physically very, very fast. And that's the difference between hepar sulph and merxol. Merxol, like hepar sulph, also has easy suppurations, also have wounds that do not heal, that fester very easily. But the way in which you can differentiate the two. One was their reaction to any kind of irritation or situation. The second is that in Merck, there is more of domination. In Hepar, there is more of a persecution feeling. So this is how you can differentiate the two remedies. The second thing are the thermals. Where Mercury is more of an ambithermal person, Hepar is chilly to the extreme degree. This is how you can differentiate the two remedies. Then you see discontented with everything. Discontented with the self as well as discontented with others. So generally there is very little in the life of Hepar self that he is not discontented or dissatisfied about. So this is what he feels. Everything is wrong. People are pushing me down. And this especially arises at work. So Hepar has a lot of, you can say, arguments or a lot of problems at his work. Because he always feels that his superiors are pushing him down. And that is why he is suffering. Hepar tends to hold other people responsible for their problems. Remember, the elements of calcarea, that is calcium and sulfur, both are present in Hepar. And both of these remedies individually, if you look at calcarea carb, which has a lot of insecurity, and sulfur, which also tends to be very critical and put the blame on others, they combine together to form Hepar sulf, which is like double of what these two remedies are. There is a very, very deep-seated feeling of suffering in Hepar self, which may or may not be a fact. They have contrary dispositions. Okay, now how do you explain contrary? Have a look. See, Hepar dislikes his own family members, dislikes his colleagues and his own friends. But he still fears for their health. There is a lot of anxiety about the health of his family, of his colleagues, of his relatives. This is very, very peculiar about Hepar because Hepar feels that these are the same people who have tortured me, who have troubled me, and yet he is anxious about their health. He feels that other people are troubling him, they are humiliating him, but he prefers being with them because he fears being alone. He doesn't like being lonely. Why? Because there's a lot of discontentment inside him. Because of which, he likes being among people. He prefers company. And yet, he does not like the people whose company he is in. So can you see how his disposition is? It's a very contrary disposition. On the one hand, he is like this. On the other, he is like that. So we can see how this is represented in the repertory. There is a very interesting rubric called contrary. So we'll do a repertory search here. Let's do a command S. A pop-up opens. Now this command S feature in Homepath Zomio helps you to look for a rubric or a keyword from any repertory and all repertories that are there in Zomio. So we'll put the word contrary. Enter. And you can see there are 32 rubrics for contrary disposition. Let's click on the first rubric, which is from the complete repertory. And you can see that Hepar is present in 4 marks in contrary. The other remedies that you see are Alumina, Anacardium, Argentum Nitricum, Chamomilla, Lachesis, Tarantula, Pulsatilla. These are the other remedies that you can think of in contrary disposition. If we see another rubric, say the rubric from Kent, which has 48 remedies. Here as well, you can see Heparsulf in grade 2. Now, I had mentioned that there is a lot of anxiety with relation to the health of relatives. Okay, let's look at this rubric. We do a command S and we type anxiety space relatives. Okay, so only two rubrics for anxiety health about relatives of. The first rubric, which has 15 remedies. Let's click on it to see which remedies are present. Heparsulf is the only remedy present in grade 4. All the other remedies are there in lower grades. Now, when you think of anxiety about the health of relatives, I think the first remedy that comes to anybody's mind is phosphorus and the next is causticum. But if you can see, it is very interesting that Heparsulf ranks much higher than either of those remedies. Now, let me tell you how you can differentiate between the anxiety health of relatives of different remedies. Okay, this will help you to understand how you can differentiate between two remedies, because when you talk about anxiety about health of relatives, there is always a reason behind that anxiety. Any anxiety has a reason, and especially an anxiety that is as specific as this about health, and that too not of the self but about the relatives, there has to be a particular reason behind it. And that reasoning helps you to differentiate between remedies. So let's look at causticum and phosphorus. Now, both of these remedies, the first word we think of for both of these remedies is sympathy. Both are extremely sympathetic remedies. Okay, but the sympathy of phosphorus is an actual genuine sympathy, because they have a sympathy and they have an empathy. Okay, they actually feel the suffering of the opposite person, and that is why phosphorus has a genuine anxiety for the health of their relatives, because they can feel the anxiety of the opposite person. If you look at causticum, there is a sympathy in causticum, but it is more of I wouldn't call it a selfish form, but they are more practical people. Causticum is more of a dominating person. The sympathy comes from the fact that they have a very strong sense of family. They want the entire family to be together in one place. And that is why they are ready to do anything for that family, which is why they have that anxiety. When I say family, I could also mean the family, the sense of family that a causticum feels at the workplace with regards to his or her team. They are very, very protective about their team because they have a strong sense of togetherness. They have a strong sense of unity, of taking one stand together. And if they feel that if anything happens to any one person in my team or in my family, then the unity will break. And that is why there is this anxiety in causticum. It's more of, there is no genuine sympathy. They just want to keep the team or the family together. If you look at the next two remedies, that is Baryta Karb and Pulsatilla, the anxiety with relation to relatives' health is because they feel a sense of dependence on those people. They are, Pulsatilla and Baryta Karb, both are extremely dependent remedies. Pulsatilla because they are more of yielding, diffident people, timid people who cannot make decisions on their own and need the help of others. Baryta Karb is because there is a genuine dimness of the intellect. When we say dimness, it doesn't really mean mental retardation. It actually means that they genuinely do not have a lot of common sense in them, which is why they are very dependent on family and relatives. And that is why these two remedies have a lot of anxiety for their relatives' health. Cocculus. Cocculus is another sympathetic remedy. Okay. Cocculus is more of a caregiver, like a mother figure. Okay. And she slips into that role very, very easily, which is why there is a lot of anxiety. Now, natrum carb has a very specific type of anxiety. The anxiety is because, again, like baryta carb and pulsatilla, there is a lot of dependence. But in natrum carb, there is dependence on a very select group of people. Could be just one person, maybe the husband or the wife or the father. And there is a lot of fear of separating from them. That is why this anxiety is present in natrum carb. Whereas in heparsulf, the anxiety stems from a basic fear of being alone. Although they are not happy with the people they have around them, they cannot do without them either. And that is why this anxiety is present in heparsulf. Now, because you remember the first key symptom we looked at was oversensitivity. Now, this oversensitivity leads Hepar to be extremely impulsive and irritable. And the impulsiveness and irritability is so intense that they can actually pick up something and hit the opposite person without even thinking. It is an impulsive behavior. It is very instinctive. It is very quick. Okay. So, they can go to the point of even stabbing a person if they are extremely angry or irritated with them. That is the level of impulsiveness in heparsulf. So, let's look at the rubric impulsive. Okay. We again go back to remedy extract. We have already added the remedy heparsulf and the chapter of the mind. Now, in the symptom keyword, we will add impulsive. I type the word impulsive and you can see two rubrics, impetuous impulsive as well as impetuous impulsive perspiration. Okay, so if you click on the first rubric where Hepar figures in grade 4, you'll see that there are three other remedies that also figure in impulsive. That is nitric acid, nux vomica, and sepia. Now, heparsulf and nux vomica are very, very similar to each other. Okay. They both are very irritable. They both are very impulsive. They both are also frowning. They are dissatisfied, discontented. But again, their reactions are very different. Although nux vomica internally is a very dominating person, when it comes to reacting, nux vomica first reacts verbally and usually reacts verbally only. The level of physical violence is almost not there in nux vomica. But in Hepar, that physical violence is there. That temporary form of madness where she actually feels like picking up her child and throwing it into the fire. It is a rubric, if you remember, and also mentioned in a lot of Materia Medica books. She has the impulse to jump out of the window, or she has the impulse to stab the opposite person in anger. This level of impulsiveness is not there in nux vomica. Nux vomica is more of a verbally reacting person rather than an actual physical reaction. When it comes to a remedy like nitric acid is a remedy that has been suffering under a feeling for many years. Okay, it is not like Hepar where she'll react extremely quickly to an acute situation. Nitric acid is more of a vindictive person. So he or she will take their time to plan their revenge and then act impulsively. Okay. So this is how you can differentiate between different remedies as well, as far as their impulsivity and irritability is concerned. Another remedy that was there in this list was sepia. Now, sepia's impulsivity is more towards the family and especially towards the husband, because her issues are always with the family and especially in most cases with the husband. So the impulsivity, the irritability that you will see in sepia is directed more towards the spouse than anyone else. Hepar self is a very hurried person. So an easier way to understand Hepar self is hurry, haste, and hypersensitivity. These are the three words that you need to remember when we talk about Hepar. Hurry, haste, and hypersensitivity. Now, you may have understood based on the hypersensitivity and the impulsiveness that Hepar self gets the person into a lot of nervous excitability. The nerves are hyperstimulated. And because of this, this causes a Hepar to be a very hurried person, a very hasty person. And in that haste, he makes a lot of mistakes. Now, another remedy that you need to think of first, along with Hepar, when you think of hurry, is sulfuric acid. Similar level of impulsiveness. But in sulfuric acid, along with the hurriedness, you will also find a lot of lethargy or prostration. Whereas in Hepar self, there is more of an oversensitivity, a chilliness, and an irritability. Violence. Now, to explain the level of violence, I will just look for this, for the extract of anger. Let's see the level of anger that Hepar self can go to that will explain this one word, violence, in Hepar. So in the symptom keyword, we put in the word anger. There are 24 rubrics for anger in which Hepar self is represented. So you have anger ailments from aggravate, anger with indignation, anger that is suppressed. Now look at this, anger in children. Now, how will you recognize a Hepar child? Okay, a Hepar child will be needlessly mean because it is angry, whenever it is angry. So if it is sitting with the mother or the sibling, if anything small that they say just irritates him, okay? Usually a child who is irritated either starts crying or starts shouting to make himself heard that he is irritable. Hepar self will kick the person or punch the person. That is the level of anger in a Hepar child, which is there for very, very small reasons. You know, the sibling just picks up a simple pencil that may belong to this Hepar child. The Hepar child will get so angry by that one gesture, which is done very innocently, he will kick his sibling. That is how you can think of Hepar self in a child. Then you have anger from contradiction, anger with a desire to kill the opposite person. That is the level of anger in Hepar self. Anger during perspiration, anger about trifles. And now look at this, anger stabbed anyone so that he could have. Such an extreme form of anger. Okay, there are only 12 remedies in this rubric, and Hepar self is the only remedy in grade 4. So anger that he could have stabbed anyone is there only in Hepar self in grade 4. The other remedies include anacardium, china, nux vomica, iodine, but not at the level that Hepar has. Now, we have understood what the mentals of Hepar sulf are. So, remember these mentals because they are instrumental in understanding why certain physical characteristics happen in Hepar sulf. So, we had the oversensitivity, we had the brooding character, we had the extreme form of irritability and impulsiveness, we have the violent form of anger, and we have the feeling of suffering and being put down by people that are close to him. Okay, these symptoms, this mental picture, this constitutional picture of Hepar sulf is going to help us now to understand the physicals. So, when I talk about oversensitivity or hypersensitivity, if it is there in any remedy at the mental level, friends, it has to manifest somewhere at the physical level. If you look at nux vomica or remedies like ignatia or natrimmune or sepia, other remedies that are extremely oversensitive, they show that same oversensitivity on the physical plane as well. So there will always be an oversensitivity to external impressions like noise, like odors, like touch. In Hepar sulf, the oversensitivity to touch is very, very intense. Okay, to the point that even a slight touch, even a very, very slight touch will aggravate Hepar sulf to the ultimate degree. So even if he gets a Hepar gets a small scratch on his skin, he will experience so much pain because there is a lot of oversensitivity to pain, again because of the overexcitation of nerves, that he will feel that this is the worst pain in the world, the pain of a small scratch. Now, when you look at the eruptions in Hepar, Hepar has a lot of oversensitive eruptions. Okay, so the eruptions of Hepar are such, because I saw this in a patient myself, that even if I take my hand near the rash, not actually touch it, I take my hand near the rash, the patient immediately felt a tingling in the skin. When I just took the fingers of my hand near the rash, he immediately felt a tingling, which was very, very painful. He felt that I've already touched him when I had not touched him at all. And this symptom is very peculiar to Hepar sulf. This symptom we may not find in the Materia Medica books. I am speaking from clinical experience. Another remedy that has this kind of fear, where you are just about to touch them and they have a lot of fear, is Arnica. But an Arnica has more of a bruised sensation, more of a sore sensation. There is a history of blunt injury or a fall in Arnica. Whereas in Hepar sulf, the feeling on the rash is more of a prickling sensation or a pricking sensation, like pins are pricking them. Okay, that same sensation is there in the throat also, the pinprick sensation. Okay, but in Hepar, if you see or experience a person coming to you with any kind of rash that has a pricking sensation or a stinging sensation, and the moment you try to touch or touch very lightly, they feel a lot of pain, think of Hepar sulf. Now, a similar sensitive rash can be seen in the remedy China as well. But where Hepar is extremely aggravated by the slightest form of touch, China is better by hard pressure or touching very firmly. China, the pain, the itchiness in the rash feels better if you hold the part of the body with the rash very firmly or apply hard pressure, they will feel better. Whereas HEPAR, even the slightest touch will aggravate them. Another level where this oversensitivity is expressed in HEPAR is the sensitivity to cold. They are so sensitive to cold that even the least form of uncovering aggravates them. Cough comes on by uncovering. The least draft of air will cause chilliness. Okay, that is the level of sensitivity or chilliness in HEPAR self. Let's have a look at an interesting rubric. We do a command S and we type chill least uncovering. Okay, now this reference, let us have a look at the reference from Fartak's repertory. Chill uncovering least. Only four remedies: HEPAR self, Nux vomica, Rustox, and Silesia. We will see ahead how HEPAR self and Silesia also come very, very close to each other. But now, if we have to differentiate between these four remedies, okay, the chilliness of HEPAR self is to the most extreme degree among these four remedies. They are so chilly that they will want the fans and the air conditioners turned off. They want all the windows closed and they want to be completely covered from head to foot. They are so aggravated by the slightest draft of air that even if anybody walks by and they feel that minimal draft of air, they will feel aggravated. That is the level of chilliness in HEPAR. Even one small part of their body, even if a finger gets uncovered, they feel cold. This is how HEPAR is. In the case of Rustox, and that is why HEPAR wants to be very still in one place. Because if they move even a little bit, it will cause chilliness. A similar manifestation is seen in Nux vomica also. The least amount of change in movement will cause Nux vomica to go into chills. But in Nux vomica, it is seen more in cases of fever. Although Nux vomica also is a very chilly patient, this is seen more in cases of fever. The chilliness of Nux vomica in a normal person is felt more in the hands and feet that are absolutely cold on touch. Okay. In the case of Rustox, even if there is a chilliness, there is also a lot of restlessness. They are physically very restless people because they have a sore sensation in their body. So along with the chilliness, there will also be a lot of restlessness. In the case of Silesia, although this patient is very chilly, just like HEPAR, extremely chilly, extremely aggravated by cold draft of air, silica will have a lot of perspiration, especially in the head, in the palms, and in the soles, where the perspiration is very offensive. So during winters, when silica feels chilliness the most, there'll be perspiration as well. Okay, this is how you can differentiate the four remedies. Suppuration. Okay, now let's have a look at a very interesting sentence that is given in Borix Materia Medica with relation to the suppuration. Okay, so let's go back to the tab of remedy, and in the books, we will select Materia Medica by Borix. Okay, let's see this. Infected sinus with pus formation, the tendency to suppuration is most marked and has been a strong guiding symptom in practice. If we go closer to the section on the skin, to jump to a particular section in this Materia Medica in these notes, click on sections and we click on skin. Look at what is written in bold capital. Unhealthy skin, every little injury suppurates. And the first line, abscesses. Suppurating glands are very sensitive. Papules prone to suppurate and extend. Acne in youth. Suppurate with prickly pain. So at every level, you see a lot of suppuration and putridity. Okay. And there is a very particular offensive smell of old cheese from the pus formation that comes out of Heparsulf. This suppuration is seen at all levels. So at the level of the skin, you will also see a similar suppuration. You will see at the level of the eyes. You will see at the level of the tonsils as well. Okay. So when you say, you know, the word quinsy, which is for pustular tonsillitis, Heparsulf has to be one of the first remedies that you think of for quinsy. Okay. Any chronic skin complaints. So when you talk about, you can talk about a chronic allergy. You can talk about a chronic urticaria, a chronic ulcer that does not heal. Chronicity of skin complaints is seen in Heparsulf. The next important characteristic of Heparsulf is the cough. Okay. Now the cough of Heparsulf is very characteristic because the slightest exposure to dry weather will bring on a dry cough in Hepar. And the characteristic is that this cough is usually preceded by or accompanied by a pricking type of pain in the throat. And whenever any part of the body gets cold or uncovered, the cough comes up.
So, to see how Hepar represents in cough in the repertory, let's go back to remedy extract. Now here, if you can see, the chapter on mind has been selected with the symptom keyword of anger. We are looking for the rubrics in which Hepar is represented for cough, and that can be viewed in the cough chapter. So the very first step that we need to take is clear the chapter of the mind, and now we add the chapter of cough. To add the chapter of cough, just type in COUGH, and now you can see those repertories in which the chapter of cough is present. Let's look at the chapter of cough in Kent and BBCR. Okay, so you select Kent and check the cough chapter of Kent. Similarly, you select BBCR and check the chapter of cough in BBCR. You click on done. So now we have selected two chapters for extract. Remember, you can select more than one chapter also from different repertories for your extract. They help you to understand how a remedy is represented in different repertories. Okay, we remove the symptom keyword of anger, and now in the extract options, because we know that Hepar will be represented in a lot of rubrics in the cough chapters, let me see only those rubrics in which Heparsulf occupies maximum gradation, that is 3, 4 and 5. In Kent's repertory, the maximum gradation is 3. Whereas in the Boninghausen repertory, it is 5. So, I deselect 1 and 2 so that only 3, 4 and 5 are selected, and I click extract. And now you can see that there are 60 rubrics in Kent as well as BBCR in which Heparsulf is represented with maximum gradations. So, cough in the evening, cough where the cold air aggravates. And now look at the nature of this cough. The nature of the cough is also like the nature of Heparsulf. to an intense degree. Very, very harsh, very, very violent, and a very intense form of cough that causes pain in the ears and in the throat as well. That is the irritation of the cough in Hepar self. It represents the irritation at the mental level. So you can see barking cough, croupy cough, cough from irritation in the larynx, a scraping type of a cough, a suffocating and spasmodic type of cough. And look here, cough uncovering aggravates. Only 8 remedies with Hepar, Rustox and Rumex occupying maximum gradation. Violent cough with 100 remedies with Hepar again occupying maximum gradation. Moving on to Bonninghausen. So an asthmatic, wheezy, spasmodic kind of cough. Barking, deep, hoarse, spasmodic, suffocating. Okay. Cough excited or aggravated by becoming cold. So even the slightest cold air or drinking cold will aggravate the cough of Hepar. And if you see, the intensity of the cough is so much that it causes watering from the eyes, lacrimation, it causes retching, it causes vomiting, and it causes weeping. The cough is so intense that the patient cries. Okay, and if you see this one rubric, cough concomitants, weeping after the attack, just one remedy, and that is Hepar Sulf. And that is because the pain because of the cough is very, very severe. It is a dry kind of cough that has no expectoration. That does not mean that there is no secretion in the lungs. The secretion is there, but a Hepar patient is unable to bring that secretion up. Very, very similar to Antemtat. So there can be a lot of rattling. But the difference between Antemtat and Hepar is that Antemtat is a very severe form of rattling, where the expectoration is more of sticky and white, whereas in Hepar you will see an infected expectoration that is more yellowish in character. Perspiration. Hepar self tends to sweat very, very easily and very, very profusely. A similar kind of easy and uncomfortable perspiration, profuse perspiration, is also seen in Merxol and it's also seen in silica. But the difference is that although Hepar self sweats very, very easily, perspires very, very easily, he still does not want to be uncovered. He is very, very chilly in spite of the perspiration. So you will see a Hepar person sweating a lot out of every pore of his body, but will not uncover, will not take off his blanket because he is an extremely chilly person. So sweats easily and profusely, but dares not uncover. Sweats without relief, easily, on every mental or physical exertion. SAR sweat. Okay, let's have a look at the extract of perspiration for Hepar self. So I will remove the chapters on cough and I will put in the chapter of sweat. Okay, now I want to specifically look for the sweat chapter of BBCR. So I select sweat from BBCR and I select all the drug marks for Hepar So I'd like to see Hepar in perspiration for all drug marks in BBCR, and I click extract. And there are 106 rubrics for Hepar perspiration. Look here, easy sweating, that is profuse, 4-mark remedy. Fetid or bad smelling perspiration, 4-mark remedy. Okay, Hepar is present in a very, very prominent state in perspiration in the repertories. Perspiration, aggravated cold air and open air. Okay, very, very remarkable symptom in Hepar, because usually perspiration tends to go down when you are exposed to open air or cold air. Okay, and the perspiration is so irritating that he feels vehement in the mind when he is perspiring. He is irritated when he is perspiring. His face becomes red when he is perspiring. And there is nausea when he is perspiring. So if any patient comes to you and says that I feel nauseated, I feel like puking whenever there's a lot of sweat, think of Hepar cells. Now modalities, aggravated by the slightest cold, by touch, by uncovering, and a very, very characteristic modality is better in damp, wet weather. Now this is very prominent because Hepar is more of a respiratory remedy. It's more of an asthmatic remedy. And asthma is usually aggravated in moist weather. But Hepar is better in damp, wet weather. Another remedy that is better in damp, wet weather is causticum. Okay. So just like causticum, Hepar also feels good in damp, wet weather. And of course, better by warmth. Now let's compare the remedies. Okay. With relation to perspiration, the easy profuse perspiration that you see in Hepar, the other remedies that compare with Hepar are Merksol and Sepia. In the extreme form of chilliness, like we saw, least uncovering causes chilliness, you have Nux Vomica. We have also compared the irritability and anger of Nux Vomica and Hepar. But where Nux Vomica is more of a verbally abusive remedy, who is not an impulsive remedy per se, Hepar is extremely impulsive and more of a physically abusive remedy. Also, in cases of suppuration, where every little injury suppurates, you also have three other remedies in the running. You have Merksol, you have Cilicia, you have Graphitis. And we also have a fourth remedy, that is petroleum. But when graphitis is more of a mild and sluggish remedy because of the carb component, Hepar is more of an impulsive remedy. Okay, Hepar is very, very angry to the point of violence, where there is a history of suffering and of feeling humiliated. Merck has a history of domination. Now, there are three remedies that come closest to Hepar self. That is Calcarea self, that we mentioned earlier, Cilicia and Nux Vomica. We have already discussed the differentiation between Hepar and Nux Vomica. Let's see the differentiation between Hepar and Calcarea self. Now, like I mentioned, where Calcarea self is suppressed, Hepar self expresses very violently. Okay, so the condition of both the remedies is the same. They both come from a background where there is a tremendous feeling of underappreciation. But a calcarea self will never react in an impulsive manner. A calcarea is usually suppressed and will complain a lot. Calcarea self is a complainer. And he will complain to anyone and everyone who is ready to listen. A lamenting remedy. But he will not do anything about it. There is a feeling of being underappreciated. but he will not take any steps to remedy that situation that he feels. He will only complain. Whereas a hepar will react in a very, very angry manner if he feels that he is underappreciated. When it comes to cilicia, there are a lot of similarities that run through these two remedies. So much so that you can get confused between these two remedies. Both are chilly, both have a very characteristic perspiration, both have the pricking sensation in the body. Okay, but where they differentiate is physically, silica is aggravated in damp wet weather, whereas hepar always feels better in damp wet weather. Now, if you look at the suppuration also in both, they are very different. In silica, the suppuration is very slow, it is very protracted, it is very sluggishly progressing suppuration. Whereas in hepar, the festering that happens very fast. It's a very rapid suppuration. That today the injury has happened, tomorrow it has got suppurated. That is the level of suppuration, the rapidity that is seen in hepar. And why this is seen, the rapidity of suppuration in hepar versus the sluggishness and slowness of suppuration in silica, is because of the mental picture that is different in both. In hepar, there is a lot of hypersensitivity. So everything in his mind also festers very fast. And that is why the reaction is very fast. That is why the festering even on the skin is very fast. Whereas in silica, there is a lot of control in silica. They are very suppressed people. Silica is a diffident remedy. It is a timid remedy because there is a lot of pressure on silica to perform. And that is why there is a constant fear of failure in silica. And that is why they are very calculated in their response. In whatever they do, they will think 100 times before taking that step. They will not feel confident enough. They don't have that grit, that decisiveness, that yes, this is what I'm going to do. Because there is that feeling that what if I fail? Okay? And that is why they progress very slowly. And that is why even the suppuration of silica progresses very slowly. This is how you can differentiate between the remedies hepar and silica that come very, very close to each other. So friends, this was the overall mental and physical picture of hepar self. This is how you can quickly extract a remedy from a patient. And the easiest way in which you can do that is if you remember the mental picture of a remedy, you can easily correlate it with the physical picture. The hypersensitivity at the mental level correlates to the hypersensitivity to pain, to touch, to cold at the physical level. The level of irritability and impulsiveness at the mental level, it immediately correlates to the easy perspiration and the rapid suppuration at the physical level, at the cough at the physical level. So this was hepar self for you. I hope that you have learned a lot about hepar self through the session as well as through Zomio. There are many, many things that you can do in Zomio to learn a remedy. This was just a few of the features or a few of the ways in which I showed you how you can understand a remedy better. So till the next session, thank you and take care.